the measure of a good product is the effect that it has on the individual, on the ability for that to improve their life, on the ability for them to have an emotional experience with the product. As industrial designers, we do what we do for the people that are using the products. I mean, that's at the forefront of what we do.
The challenge that Acer presented to us was to design a future set of products for creatives that would take away the barriers of producing something creative.
We're a fairly small program of 12 people, and so it's a very tight-knit group with close contact with our professors who each bring a great level of expertise. It's a close mentorship process throughout the program.
The final deliverables for this project were three fully conceptualized products presented through a series of renderings and physical scale models that you could pick up and touch, try out the ergonomics of. One of the first things we did was that all 14 of us went and just came up with as many ideas as we could, sketched all we could, and then spent hours going through pages and pages and throwing that one away and, all right, bring this one here and let's add on to this.
As a team, we were able to have a discussion about the benefits, the drawbacks of each direction, the merits of each design.
When I build something, I really think about the function, what this product's going to do, and if it's going to work. Because a product that looks beautiful, that doesn't work, is not a beautiful product. When I learned about the collaboration with Acer, I was very thrilled because it gives us students real-world experience at a student level. Acer was able to give us computers that we can use. Once you get a ConceptD and you see the resolution, you see the vibrant colors, you see that sharpness, then you know that you're using a really impressive computer.
The three products that we ended up designing for Acer, one of them is a gestural mouse. It has two touch surfaces on either side of the mouse, and that allows for really intuitive interactions with your programs, and it would allow for you to customize those interactions to be the best suited for the user.
We took some inspiration from interviews with architects, designers, cinematographers. One of the needs that we found was to have a portable 3D scanner that would also allow you to capture information from your environment. We saw a number of different applications for field research. For VFX artists, they now send people into the field to capture three-dimensional data, which they then can put into rendered environments around physical actors. It's really difficult to draw on a vertical surface. So you're limited to maybe two people drawing at the same time, and you're obscuring the view from all the others that would like to see. We conceived of a table that would seamlessly transition between tabletop format that would be excellent for drawing, for collaboration, and then transition to a vertical position so that you could share work with others and it could function just as a normal SMARTBOARD.
The renderings of the products actually require a fair amount of computing power.
ConceptD is a really good machine for rendering because it has the processing power of a high-performance desktop, but it's in a laptop form. As the product becomes more of a finished product, I switch to becoming a builder or a finisher, making sure that we have prototypes that we can use to test on people and get their feedback, and then further down as examples to the clients.
There's a number of different ways that this project has helped put us through the paces as industrial designers.
Acer challenged us to have an accessible product for everyone and to implement sustainable processes.
Working with Acer has given me more confidence in what I've been learning. It gives students a better idea of how to work in the real world, which means that you're going to have more innovation and more skilled people coming in to make more change.
This project has really expanded our perspective in working with a client and actually talked face to face with some of the leaders of the computer industry. Really understanding more about this world of how products are made and conceived and considered and delivered to a final user. It's just been an incredible learning opportunity to engage with how products are made.